Hello YouTube, this is a Satsu 5 and I got a new gun or an old gun depending on your point of view. New to me but old to the world. Yeah, I got a new gun at a gun show. I've had it for a few weeks, have not shot it yet, but I thought, you know what, I need to put some content on my YouTube channel. And because I haven't been putting up a lot of content here lately, I'm hoping to change that. But I was trying to wait until I actually shot the gun and actually film a review on it, but I thought, what the heck, let's just do a show-off video to show off my new gun. You may like that. If you're a gun person, you might like watching this. No shooting, no cleaning, no review. It's just a show-off. I'm going to talk about the gun. I'm going to talk about why I bought it, why I didn't buy the other gun, and my expectations of this gun. First off, I traded my Beretta Cheetah for this gun, which I found kind of funny because I bought that Cheetah for a very specific purpose, to get my concealed handgun license, which I'm planning on doing very, very soon, because as of September 1st, not only do we get better knife laws, but they lowered the price of these concealed handgun course, the permit fee. So I have no excuse. I can afford it. I need to get it. So, I traded a gun that would have been perfect to qualify with, but just not as cool as this gun. Now, what is this gun that I'm looking at? Well, if you read the title, you know it's a Colt Model 1903 Pocket Hammerless. Some of you might not know what a Colt 1903 Pocket Hammerless is, so I'm about to show you. Here is the gun. It is a John Browning design, and it's a 32 ACP, kind of a downgrade to the 380 that I have. It doesn't carry as much in the magazine, but it is a cool gun. Now, what makes this gun cool? It is a gangster gun, quite literally. Now, this isn't traced back to any particular gangster, but this model gun was very popular with the criminal underworld at the time. Al Capone carried one. Al Capone's accountant carried one. Bonnie Parker from Bonnie and Clyde taped one of these to her thigh to break Clyde out of jail or prison. I can't remember if it was jail or prison. Might have been prison. And John Dillinger was found with one of these when he was shot. Now, some people say that the law planted this gun on him. I guess that is completely possible, but according to the history books, and if we were to trust history, John Dillinger carried one of these. Now, I'm going to go ahead and make this gun safe, because it's not good enough that I know the gun's safe. I check the gun every time I pick it up, but it's just common courtesy for everybody else to see that it's safe. Nothing in the chamber, nothing in the magazine. It's now on safe. And a lot of criminals carry this. This was the concealed handgun of the time. The cat's meow, I guess you can say. Also, George S. Patton carried one of these. I think it was a nickel finish with ivory grips. And there was a famous story about a reporter asking about his pearl grips, and he got really ticked off, and he was like, "I don't carry a gun with pearl grips. Only pimps and New Orleans gamblers carry guns with pearl grips." He had ivory. But this is also a military gun. Now, this one in particular wasn't issued to anybody in the military, but there are still some floating around with military U.S. government property marks on them, and Colt has even made a reproduction of the military gun that has the U.S. property marks on it. Colt isn't making it; a third party is making it. And I really don't like that gun because it's claiming to be something that it's not. It's not a Colt being made in the Colt factory, and it's not a U.S. military gun. It just has that stamped on it. To me, it's like false advertisement. But this is a original Colt made in Hartford, Connecticut. According to the Colt website, this was made in 1920, and this gun was issued to general officers. General officers weren't necessarily the combatives. If you're going into combat, you generally got a 1911. If you're going to see some rough action, but if you're a general officer, you still need a sidearm, but you don't necessarily need a 1911. You need something a little bit more refined and gentlemanly, I guess you can say. This is kind of your more elegant military gun for the general officer. 42 ACP. You can see the sights are kind of sparse on them. Let's see if I can line it up. Not really. There we go. I traded my Beretta for this. Now, let me tell you the story of why I got this gun. Story time. I brought my Beretta to this gun show not with the intention of trading it, it's just in case I find something that I can't live without. And I walked around and I found this FN, I think it was an FN 1910 in 42 ACP, and I was there looking for a 42 ACP, a Beretta 4042, which is a Beretta pocket pistol. They didn't have the Beretta 4042, they had the Beretta Bobcat, which is a 22. I didn't necessarily want the 22. I mean, if someone gave it to me, I'd want it, but I didn't necessarily want to trade for it. But they had an FN 1910, but it was a Nazi gun. It had Nazi proof marks on it, which, to tell you my point of view when it comes to buying artifacts, I have no problem personally owning a Nazi gun. If I bought a Luger, a Walther PP or PPK, or in this case, an FN, I have no problem owning that gun if it has Nazi proof marks on it. The Nazi proof marks are relatively small. I personally don't uphold those beliefs or ideology. I don't like the Nazis, but it's a historically significant gun. You know that I like historically significant things. I like history and historical weapons, and I personally would have no problems owning that gun. But I thought to myself, what if I get this gun and I'm showing it to people and people think that I'm part of that party, if I'm part of that belief system? I didn't want people to think of me that way. I looked at this gun, I walked by it, I walked past it several times, and I was like, it's a cool gun, I would really like it, but what would people think of me? So I walked around a little bit and I came across this gun and I recognized it. I was like, oh man, Colt 1903, made in America, gangster gun, sold. So I got this. And just to tell you how serious I am about getting my concealed handgun permit, I bought a holster for it. Very simple, ambidextrous, inside the waistband, outside the waistband holster, just slides in. I am planning on carrying this when I get my license. I'm not going to qualify with it. I think I'm going to borrow my brother's 9mm to qualify with, because I think he's going to take the class with me and we're going to like split ammo and stuff, qualify with the same gun. Just it has better sights, and I definitely want to practice with this a lot more. I haven't shot it yet. But I definitely want to practice with this a lot more before I qualify with it, or before I feel comfortable carrying it. But I've shot Glocks. I shot a Glock 10mm, so shooting a Glock 10mm is pretty expensive. So just share my gun with my brother, the 9mm. So I think I'm gonna qualify with that. But yeah, just to tell you something pretty cool about this gun. I tried to film this video several times. I can't remember what all I've said. Bonnie Clyde, Al Capone, Al Capone's accountant, and John Jellinger were known to carry this. George S. Patton carried this and supposedly shot at a German airplane with it. I think I said all those things in this video or in this take. But tell you something else that's pretty cool about this gun. If you go on eBay and you search Colt 1903 or 1908, Colt never called it the 1908, but there was a second variant of this that shot 380. And I kind of wish I had the 380 version, but the 32 was much more popular than the 380. Don't know why. But if you sort your Colt 1903, 1908, you can still get newly made custom grips for these. You can get burl wood, you can get micarta, I think you can get G10, you can get synthetic ivory, you can get pearl, you can get newly made holsters for these things. Apparently, these. I don't. It's probably not the most popular carry gun these days, but apparently, this is still a valuable option to carry because of all the new stuff you can buy for it. Yeah, I put this on the Colt website, and it says it was made in 1920. And what else? Like I said, I tried to film this video several times. I'm forgetting what I've said and which take. Okay, I'm not going to break it down and field strip it, but I'm going to show you how this thing breaks down. Pull the slide back, I usually squeeze it, and I put pressure and start turning the barrel, and then I release my grip slowly, and as you can see, the barrel twists. I'm not going to disassemble it, but as that barrel twists, the slide comes off. That's how you field strip it. They call this the pocket hammerless because you can't see a hammer. That is actually not true. It actually has a hammer in it. This is just a shroud. Some other core features. This is this isn't the oldest variant, but it's not the newest variant. It was made in 1920. But the cool thing about mine is that it does not have a magazine disconnect. Now, this isn't a big issue with a heel release or a European heel release. You're not going to accidentally drop this magazine in the middle of a gunfight. But I like the fact that... let's see. Take the magazine out. I like the fact that it does not have a magazine disconnect. It does have a grip safety. It does have a manual safety. And that manual safety cannot be actuated unless you cock the gun. Now, this isn't the ideal carry gun in my opinion, but I am planning on carrying it just because it's cool and I like carrying cool stuff. But my next gun on my list is a Warthor PPK, either an antique or a Smith & Wesson variant. If I get a newly made one, I kind of want the Smith & Wesson, but I'm kind of into the antique guns, as you can probably tell with my FN. I'm not going to safety check this because it has nothing in the chamber, but it has something in the magazine, and I know that, and I don't need to prove that to you. I'm just going to put it back in its place, and we'll not mess with it. So yeah, this is a cool gun. I plan on carrying it. I plan on getting my concealed handgun license. And hopefully here, somewhat near future, I'll get me a Warthor PPK or some other cool gun, antique gun, hopefully. But yeah, this is my new gun. I plan on shooting it and doing a full review on it. And you might wonder, why would you review an antique? Well, they're still out there. They'll still be in circulation. You can still find them, and there are newly made replicas of these, so it might be a good idea to review an antique gun if you can still get it, and you may want to consider buying one of these. So I'm going to review it, and hopefully you'll enjoy the review. Like I said in my Beretta video, I'm into metallic guns. I like a heavier gun because I have relatively shaky hands. They kind of twitch a little bit. And I feel a heavier gun stabilizes. I'm not like waving it around. It's not like drifting as much. Also, a metallic gun is heavier, so it's less felt recoil, in my opinion. I'm not afraid of recoil, but if you shoot a gun that... all day or for a long period of time, if one's more enjoyable to shoot than the other, then why not shoot the one that's more enjoyable? I mean, I shot 44 magnums one-handed just for the fun of it. I shoot a Glock 10mm with some pretty hot loads. It doesn't really bother me, but if a gun is more enjoyable to shoot, like on the opposite end of the spectrum, the 22, then why not shoot the 22 because it's more enjoyable, you know? That's why I like shooting my Ruger Mark III. It's a more enjoyable gun to shoot than, you know, a 50 caliber AE where you might smack yourself in the face. So that's the theory on why I like metallic guns. And I also like culturally and historically significant guns. And that's that. Did I show you my holster? Why am I asking you if I showed you my holster? Because you cannot answer me in real time. But for just in case I didn't show you, I tried filming this video several times. There was my holster. It's an Allen, and it's inside or outside the waistband. I do plan on carrying this. So that's it. I hope y'all have a great day. I hope you enjoyed this video. I'm Satsu5, and I'm out.